In this video, we are going to see how to use a ByteScout barcode reader SDK to read the barcodes. Let's get started. So here we are having few barcodes, one in the code 39 format, one in code 139 format, and one QR code. And we are going to utilize these images and going to read the what is it is containing. So I'm going to create a new console application. And let us say like I'm going to add a reference ByteScout barcode reader SDK. Here it is. Also, I'm going to add all these sample images. And making sure these are contained in the bin folder. So copy always. Okay, our plan is very simple. So first of all, we are going to create the instance of the reader class. Then we are going to specify which barcode type to read. Then we're going to load file and basically output. Okay, so let's get started. So I'm adding reference ByteScout.barcode reader. Now let us create the reader object. I'm going to pass the registration name and key here. So I'm using the demo key. So it is having the limitation, like all the text are not extracted, means some of them has the masking. But if you purchase it, then this you will utilize the full power of this. But this will do the thing, like basically this will demonstrate like how it is going to read it perform. I'm going to specify which barcode to read from, like barcode types dot find dot, let us see for the code 128 here, code 128. So here you can see like it is providing the wide range of the barcodes here. And if you are not sure about like which barcode to read, you can basically provide like all equal to true, but it's not preferred way, like it will increase the CPU cost. So if you know like which type of barcode it is, it's good to specify it. So we have enabled the code 128 here. We are loading the file reader.read from file. So if you see like here, there are various options available. Like you can read from the PDF file, PDF file page, you can read from the stream, you can read from the bitmap. So right, just reading from file here and going to provide the file name. And let us see what is the output. So if reader dot found count greater than 0, which means it is containing the output. And let's see how many barcodes it is containing. So I'm getting the instance of the found barcode. These collections, found barcode. So all the barcodes it found will be here in this array. Okay. And let me write it on the console, console.writeline. Found barcode dot value and type. type. Okay, and let me pause the console here. I guess we are ready to go. Let's see. I'm going to start the page, and here it is. It has found one code 128 type barcode, and here's the value. So this text is due to we are using the demo keys. Now let us see how it is performing for this type. You can either replace this, or you can in addition to barcode type, like here. So if you are more than one or two types of barcodes, so you can specify as many types as you like. Let's see the output. Okay, it has found a code 39, and let's also add a QR code reader dot barcode types dot found dot QR code, and let's see the output. Here it is. Okay, so this is this much of easy to utilize the barcode reader class from the Byte Scout.